Welcome, my friend. Seven Gray here. Thank you for joining me for this episode today. I'm excited for today because I'm beginning on my electronic setup of my solar build. I'm going to be doing solar panels on the roof of my new cargo trailer, which you can see in the background here. This is a renowned cargo trailer. I bought it just a few weeks ago. I'll link the episode above where I traveled up to Georgia and purchased that. This video is sponsored by renowned cargo trailers. I'll be towing the cargo trailer with this flatbed pickup truck, which I purchased and have been doing lots of work on. It's almost dialed in, pretty happy with it. And over here is the cargo trailer. It's 26 feet long, 8.5 foot ceiling inside, so that after I get the insulation, I'll still have a standard 8 foot ceiling like a house. Behind me is the step van, which is still for sale. I have a few leads. I think I might have it sold here in the near future, but if you're interested, contact me ASAP because I think it's going quickly. Today I'm starting work on my electronics, my wiring of my solar setup. Let me show you where I'm going to be putting that. This is the passenger side of the cargo trailer. You can see the wheel wells here. So the power and electric will be located just in front of the wheel wells in this area here on the inside panel. So it's going to be located right about here going up the wall. For the past several weeks, I've been living inside of an empty rental property. As you can tell from the echo here, it's just really empty. It's a little bit strange to be living in a mostly empty house. This is the living room area here. You can see it's just a big empty room. There's really not much here other than just my shoes and a few things here by the door. This is a three-bedroom house, and I've taken two of the bedrooms, one to sleep in and one which I've made into sort of my office and workspace. So right now I'm in the office workspace. I have a camp desk set up here and my camp chair set up next to it, which is really squeaky and makes lots of noise. And then I took a door that I had replaced here recently, put it on some sawhorses inside of the bedroom, and so I am putting together all of the electronic components. Here you can see a myriad of components that are going into my build. Let me talk about those. What you're seeing here involved a lot of work, and I had a lot of help from Scott down in San Diego with this. Scott helped me with my initial components and build that I put together in the step van. He's been highly valuable and his advice has been just fantastic for helping me put together this diagram and all the components which you see here. So let's go through this very quickly. I have six solar panels. These will be about 350 watts each. I still have to purchase these out in Phoenix, Arizona, which I'll be going there very, very soon. So there's six panels and these feed with a disconnect switch into three different solar charge controllers. So I could have done this with one solar charge controller. The cost is about the same, very, very little difference between three charge controllers and one charge controller. The advantage of having three is that if a frisbee or a light pole casts a shadow on one of these panels, it doesn't drop the power on all six. It'll only drop the power on two of the panels. And this also gives me redundancy if one of the units goes bad or something like that. I have a lot more options. So I opted to go with three charge controllers. I'm doing Renergy here, a combination of Renergy and Victron, which you'll see later. And another new component that I'm going to have is lithium batteries. I've decided to build my own lithium battery banks. And this is really based largely on Will Prowse's videos on his channel, which probably you've all seen. If not, you can check out that. There's very detailed videos on how to put these together. So I'm going to do battery banks, a total of three eventually, but I'm starting with two and I've purchased all of the components to make two of those. So it's going to be eight cells, as you see here, connected to a battery monitor. And they'll be connected to a DALI battery management system, a BMS. And I've got two BMS units, as you can see here, and then a 300 amp switch. All the gauges and wires have all been pretty much outlined by Scott with the distances that I'm going to be using, and they are clearly labeled here. So if you're interested in building a similar system, you're welcome to use this diagram. So these feed into a common bus bar, and then they will be monitored by a smart shunt from Victron, which has a Bluetooth module that goes to a phone. So you can view it here on a little hockey puck screen that can be mounted on the side of the power box to visually see it, or be anywhere within Bluetooth range, and you can see very complex diagrams of what's happening with the charging and with the health of the batteries through this smart shunt, which is really the wonderful thing about Victron. So I do have that. Everything's feeding into these two bus bars, which you can see here in the middle of the diagram, and then all of the components that are going to be fed off of that tie into this. So the components that I'm going to be running are three things, really. First is going to be a converter. This is a 24 volt system, everything here. So I need to step that down to 12 volt to be able to run standard 12 volt electronics. So this here is a converter to step everything from 24 down to 12, and then it feeds into a fuse box where all of my components like lights and USB plugs and other things, water pumps, things like that, will run off of this, ceiling fans, all that kind of stuff. This is very, very similar to what I have in the step van right now. In fact, it's the same fuse box solution. The one different thing on this particular build is I'm going with two inverters. I'm going to have a high efficiency inverter that doesn't power a lot of components, and then I'll have a big inverter which will power almost anything, but it's very inefficient, at least it's less efficient than the Victron. So the Victron here is only 1200 watts, and it's intended to run things overnight that are going to require power and be as efficient as possible. So this stays on all of the time, and it only supplies 1200 watts. So I'm planning on running a 120 volt upright fridge. Other items like a split AC I can run off of this, and it will all run just fine and be very, very efficient. And then when I don't need efficiency, but I need high power for things like a microwave or an induction cooktop or things along those lines, and I need high power, then I can turn on this second inverter just for a short period of time. It's up to 3 kilowatts. It's a 3K inverter, and it should run just fine. And it converts everything from 24 volts over to 120 volts. And I can do something like an air popper if I want. I have disconnects on everything, breakers here, so I can not only protect the units, but be able to turn them off as needed. Lastly, I have a Shore Power battery charger. This is a Victron unit and allows me to plug into Shore Power and plug and run the whole system, as well as charging the batteries if, say, I go to Washington State or Oregon, where it's overcast a lot, and I'm able to plug in a friend's driveway or RV park or something like that. So I do have that option. So that's pretty much the entire system. And many, many thanks to Scott for helping me assemble all of those components. I chose a lot of them myself, but he also gave me some direction and tweaking some of the components for maximum efficiency and to get higher quality components. So I'm really, really thankful to him for all of his help. It's been dozens and dozens of emails over the last 2 months. And I've purchased all of these items recently. I'll be putting Amazon affiliate links below if you want to build a similar system. I'll be uploading the wiring diagram to my website. I'll include a link below to that in case you want to download that for building your own system. So I don't think I mentioned that the six panels are going to give me about 2 kilowatts of solar power that feed into these three charge controllers here, disconnect switches from the solar panels down to charge controllers, and then they feed into the rest of the system. These are the bus bars here. There is a disconnect in here between the charge controllers and the bus bar, and this is my 24-12 converter to convert everything down for 12 volts that I need to run inside with a disconnect for it, and then the little fuse box. Over here I have my Ames charger that charges from shore power to charge the lithium batteries. Here is the high efficiency inverter that I purchased. It's a Victron unit, and then my lower quality 3000 watt inverter when I need to run big stuff. And then I have disconnects for each of these three components. And then lastly, I have my batteries. I've put out 8 of the cells right now just to get an idea of the size. These are really, really nice battery units here. And they have these little caps that go on the end, which is very convenient and very nice. And then I have 2 of these DALI BMS units that are going to be doing the battery management of balancing the cells. So that's a lot. I have been on the learning curve the last 4 years for dealing with solar, and I think I have a pretty good grasp at this point of how the whole thing goes together. I'm really excited to have this. This is almost 3 times the system, the power and the capacity that I had in the step van. So it's going to be quite an upgrade for me, and I'm really excited about it. And the things that it's going to be able to power, like a surround sound system, an upright fridge, things like that, are going to be really a fun, awesome way to upgrade my quality of life. That's all I wanted to give you for this episode. I just wanted to sort of show you the wiring diagram, all the components that I've purchased, and what I'm assembling together. I still need to purchase the wire to connect all the components and all the terminal lugs to go on those and crimp those together and get everything wired together and mounted into boards and boxes. Next video will probably be me top balancing the lithium batteries and putting them in boxes. So that's what I'm planning on doing next in my project. Thank you so much for watching, and special thank you to Scott for helping me out with putting together this entire system. Really appreciate that. Please savor the moment, and I'll see you in a future video.